It used to be that when a new framework or library version released, we developers would be excited to load up the documentation and start to pore over all the different new features that had been introduced. However, as of today, a lot of us are relying on AI tools to assist us with coding. And so the first question nowadays is, can I use this new version with AI assistance? So in the middle of this transition of using AI more and more in our workflow, we get Svelte 5. A brand new version with a lot of changes both under the hood, but also syntax-wise with the introduction of runes. And this has changed most of Svelte's syntax between version 4 and 5. So today we're going to talk about how you can get great AI assistance for Svelte 5 and the latest version of SvelteKit, and minimize instances of getting old syntax. First, let's talk about some of the problems that exist with LLMs today that still hasn't been solved. So, the first problem is cutoff dates. Every LLM has a date when the creator of the LLM stops collecting information and starts training. And adding information after this date is not really possible. So you might see that ChatGPT or Claude list a cutoff date of something like November 2023 or January 2024, something like that. And that means that past that date, there is nothing inside the LLM itself that can be updated or that has been updated. So the only way to add new data is through the sort of chat interface by feeding it new data before we ask a question. And the second problem with LLMs are training bias. So let's say even if you have a new version of the data that you need, like let's say that you use an LLM that had time to scrape the Svelte 5 alpha documentation, like before it was released. The fact that you have a lot more Svelte 4 documentation out there than Svelte 5 means that you will have this like training bias where the LLM will think that, well, clearly Svelte 4 must be the correct way to do things, and maybe the Svelte 5 is just like a different way of doing it. So you will get a lot of old syntax rather than new syntax. And a follow-up problem to this is mixing syntax. So you get like a little bit of Svelte 4 and then a little bit of Svelte 5. And so all of these problems exist today and we have to solve them somehow. So let's have a look at how we can do that. So to solve this problem, we can use something that is called context. So LLMs are really, really smart. So even if they haven't seen something before and we tell them about some new things, like we, let's say, preload the documentation for Svelte 5 and the latest version of SvelteKit, they're going to be smart enough to quote unquote learn this new version, or at least learn what are the changes and internalize it into itself and give us better answers that way. So what we will do in this video is to preload the Svelte 5 and SvelteKit documentation into an LLM and see how we can get it to give you basically like really good results, even though this LLM has never known anything about Svelte 5 and has never learned anything about Svelte 5. And I'm also going to show you how you can set up a good starting prompt, so basically telling it to use like Svelte 5 and to use runes and all of that stuff. So how do we preload the docs into the context? Well, it's going to depend a little bit on what kind of LLM you're dealing with. With coding, there's roughly two different types of LLMs. There's the chat completion LLM, which is you're asking the Copilot or whatever you're using, like a question, like can you implement this new feature in my code? And the second is code completion. So that is like when you're typing something and then the LLM will like suggest the continuation of whatever it is you're typing. And so from what I know, there is currently no way to preload like docs into code completion LLMs, so the ones that complete the code. Now, there are some code completion companies that are working with really large context for your project. One of these companies that I've been experimenting with is Supermaven. And technically, so if you have the documentation inside your project, then Supermaven, that has 1 million tokens worth of context, is supposed to be able to pick that up. Although I haven't tried it long enough to actually like see the benefits of this. Instead, I'm going to kind of focus on preloading the context into the second type of LLM, which is the chat LLM. So the ones where you can just ask questions to it. And there are many ways of doing it. You know, you have these AI IDEs like Cursor and continue.dev. And of course you have Copilot. So each one of these, I should say, services is going to have a different way for putting documentation in. But what's important to keep in mind is that you really want that full context. So you want the LLM to take in the whole documentation into the prompt. Because a lot of these tools, they actually give you something called RAG, which is basically like just like a fancy way of doing search inside the documentation. And that is not as good as putting the documentation into context, because you're just picking out small pieces of the information, and there's no guarantee that those pieces will be in any way related to your question. I mean, preferably they should be, but the performance of it, from my experience, it's not good. So what you really want to do is to put the whole docs into context, and I will use a service for this in this video to show it off and to show off how good the results can be. And I'm using this service because I know that it puts the whole docs into the context. And the service I'm gonna show in this video is Claude Projects. So let's get into the video and let's see what we can do. All right, now it's time to try to see if we can preload the Svelte 5 docs into Claude Projects, and we're gonna see what kind of the performance will look like and how well it works. But first, we need to figure out a way to actually take the whole docs from svelte.dev, you know, this docs section, and convert it into some type of format that we can easily add to Claude Projects, because we don't want to be like copy-pasting the docs page by page into the LLM here. So how can we do that? So when I was searching around for this, I came across this site called LLMCTX. So this is a project by a person called Didier Katz. And this project has a bunch of different presets for different frameworks, where you can basically click a link and you get the docs. And so this was good, and I used this for a while, but then I found a few issues specifically with the Svelte presets. Like, it wasn't using the latest version of the docs from the Omni site, the svelte.dev site. It had some problems with the minification. And so I submitted a few pull requests to this site, and the Svelte presets are a lot better now. But I also felt like I needed a playground to kind of experiment with the preset, that experiment with different sizes of presets, because different LLMs can take different amount of content. So it would be nice if there were some larger presets and some smaller presets, and you can kind of like pick the one that would work best for your type of LLM that you're using. And so what I did was I forked this site that was graciously open source, and I forked it into this site that I called svelte-llm. And so you can see the DNA of the other site here. They have a similar type of look and feel. But on this site, I have done a few improvements. And one thing that I've done is that I've added a few different presets. So for example, for Svelte 5, we have a full preset that will give you like everything, so the entirety of the Svelte 5 docs. And then we have a medium preset that will give you everything except like the legacy docs and like the reference documentation. So we can see here, and we can also see here how that impacts the file size. So the full documentation for just Svelte 5 is 383 kilobytes. That's quite a lot of text. And the kind of reduced one is 209 kilobytes. So we have the Svelte 5 docs, we have SvelteKit docs, we have the legacy documentation down here. If you're still on Svelte 4, this is actually getting the old content JSON from the old site. But these new ones, they use a text format. And so I've been experimenting a lot, and I've come up with this recommended medium preset. And this preset has the entirety of the Svelte and SvelteKit docs, but we take away like a few sections, like about maybe like doing packaging, like i.e. if you want to create new packages for Svelte, or like some of the more advanced adapter documentation. Like, it's a bit of a waste to put in the whole Cloudflare adapter documentation if only a small percentage of people are going to use it. So what we did here is that we took away some stuff, and we managed to get it down to a still acceptable for many LLMs, you know, right now 470 kilobytes. Although this is being live updated, this is being updated every day. So by the time you visit the site, the size can be probably not smaller, but probably a little bit larger as we get new features in Svelte 5 and SvelteKit. The site is super easy to use. We just click on this recommended preset that's going to download it for us. And now I'm going to put it into Claude. I have the page up here for creating a new Claude project. And this is kind of Claude's way of creating a space where you can have all of your like documentation and code and all the other stuff in it to easily be able to create chats from. So I'm going to call this project Svelte 5 programming. There we go. And here is the main interface. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to upload this file that I just downloaded. I'm going to drag it in here. There we go. And we see even though we have reduced the file, it still takes up quite a lot of the like knowledge capacity. And this will depend between different LLMs, so it's not like a fixed number. That's why we offer different presets. That's done. And now we need to set a few custom instructions. And this is kind of like the kind of custom instructions that will be prepended before every chat in addition to the docs. I have a little prompt here. It's nothing really special here. It's basically saying, you know, you are expert AI assistant. You will be using Svelte 5 and SvelteKit 2. Use TypeScript, please, and a bunch of other small stuff. Like I can link this these instructions in the video. It's nothing special. All right, and so now we have everything we need, and I'm going to show a few demos here, and I'm going to use the Svelte REPL just to show you that they work correctly. So let's load up the Svelte REPL and let's write a prompt. So I'll start. Well, actually, before we start to build something complex, let's see if this actually like has the information about Svelte specific features. So one of the things that I, for example, wanted to ask it about is this new Svelte map that, if you look here in the docs, it is actually referenced only here. This is the only thing that kind of shows you how Svelte map works. But I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to ask Claude, can you tell me about Svelte map? And because the docs are preloaded, then hopefully Claude is going to be able to figure this out and tell me about how to use it. Let's see. And so it's been writing for a while. And let's see here. Svelte map is a reactive version. It's imported from Svelte Reactivity. This is correct. And it gave me a little example here on how to use it. And to my eyes, this looks fairly complete, fairly correct. Let's give it a try in the playground. All right. So I did an example. I haven't modified anything. And it just it seems to work just fine. So I can only conclude that worked well. And one other thing that I wanted to kind of show off is this brand new feature that came just literally a few days ago, which is error boundaries. So let me start a new chat and ask it about error boundaries, because we have the docs, so it should be able to figure that out. Let's have a look. All right, so it wrote some code here. What I'm really interested in here is kind of to see if the basic syntax is right, like Svelte colon boundary, that is the correct syntax. It gave us an example here. Again, I do think this looks correct to me, just looking at it briefly here. Let's paste it and see if it actually works in the REPL. All right, so it did this very very nice example. You can increment, but you can also throw an error. And when you do, you see the error in the console. How cool is this? So this is all we had to do. We just had to download the docs, we had to put it in the LLM, and we get really, really good and first and foremost, correct code completion for these brand new features that came out just a few days ago. All right. So that was really fun. Let's crank it up. Let's try to do something a little bit more complicated. I'm going to go ahead and ask it to write a tic-tac-toe game using runes. All right, we have a little tic-tac-toe game here. Let's try to paste it in. And I think here we will need to switch to the light mode, just because sometimes the font size, the font color doesn't correctly show in the dark mode. All right, so it's telling us the current player. It has the board here, and I can play it. There we go. That seemed to work okay. Let's see if the win condition works. Yes, it says player X wins. So it just worked. Like, this is what you call a zero shot. So I just asked it to do something with one prompt, and it did it right away. Let's see here. It did this like TypeScript interfaces because we asked it to write TypeScript. It used state correctly for the different game states. It typed it correctly. The only thing I wanted to see here is if it used derived for the game status. And yes, it did use derived by correctly because it's using a function here. So it just works. And as kind of a final thing, I wanted to show you that this, since we preloaded the preset that also has SvelteKit in it, let's also ask it to create a basic SvelteKit form and see if that works correctly. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, so it wrote a bunch of stuff here, and I don't have a SvelteKit project right now, so I'm gonna just look at this code with my eyes without running it and see if it looks okay. So let's first start with the basic component. It's using enhance for the form, all correct. It sets this action to add. It has error handling, and it gets correctly both the data and the form from props, which is how it would work in a plus page file. But it's using the new props syntax instead of export let. And then this is the form actions on the server side. And this has been the same even before Svelte 5, so this is maybe not as exciting, but we can see here that it adds the add action correctly. It gets the form data. So everything here looks totally, totally fine. It even implemented a little in-memory store here to keep the guestbook entries. So that's it. That's the whole video, basically. I think this is a really cool demo of just how far AI models have come, and how easy we can teach them new tricks by preloading like the latest version of the documentation. What you can also do, which I haven't touched so much on in this video, is that you can actually also put your entire code base in here. So imagine that you have a SvelteKit project and you also add the SvelteKit project. You merge all of the like files in your SvelteKit project into one big file and you upload it into Claude Projects. And that way you can kind of work with your entire project, and you can ask it to edit specific files or add specific routes, all that kind of stuff. And I actually have a separate video about that I did a few months ago. And I will put a link here somewhere to it if you want to check that out. So that's kind of taking it to the next level, but now with a Svelte 5 twist to it. So thanks so much for watching. Let me know if you've tried this out. Let me know if you how you like the presets that are on the svelte-llm side and site, and if there's anything I can do to improve them. And just let me know if you have any other ideas for videos or for stuff that you'd like to hear more about. Thanks so much for watching.